Do you see there is a future for your style of business inhabiting that space in the market as a re-roller in Europe, where possibly there might not be for a low-cost steelmaking base, for example?
Well, I think that Marcegaglia has a very specific, I would say unique, strategic positioning. The first feature of this strategic positioning, as you properly pointed out, we are in the re-rolling, tube making, service center, and I would add it's carbon, high carbon, it's a mix of commodity and specialty, it's carbon and stainless. So I would say that the main two features are the very wide range of products and diversification of markets, together with not being involved heavily in the upstream in Europe with European cost in the global picture. So that means that when the market is particularly good, maybe we've lost some business opportunity from profit opportunity. The big steel mill have made good money, but on the other hand, they've been also squeezed by the mining people, so the iron ore producers and so on. So life has become more volatile and more difficult to predict for the non-low-cost producers such as the European one. We are, on the opposite, brokeraging and using the flexibility very heavily from one market to another, from one product to another, from one source to another. And so I would say that the next decade feature, which I consider could be winning for a company, is in fact flexibility. I believe that volatility of demand and consequently volatility of price has become more and more intense, and I believe that would be a feature also of the steel market, both carbon and stainless, for the future, and the ability to read ahead of the others and to very promptly react through a flexible approach and business model from sourcing to converting to selling, it's very crucial. So I would define flexibility in that respect a very important feature for the steel successful company of the future.
I mean, it's an interesting point of view when you look at the investments being made in China. How have you found investing in China? Has it been easy?
So far, very easy, very welcome, very supported by the local government. It is important to say that steel production has been targeted by the Chinese government as a very strategic investment. So the production of steel has been limited to foreign investor as a minority player compared to other downstream, where, for example, we have decided to put a greenfield project in the area of 150 million euro of capex plus current assets. And that is, it's been possible as according to our style, which is 100% owned from us. The investment has been planned less than 3 years ago, has been decided 2.5 years ago, it's been started for construction about 1.5 years ago, and everything has come on stream like that, with cheap cost, very professional subcontractor, including the Chinese one, and the very full support of the government. That has been really wonderful and very, very supportive. So we believe we will start production very soon. So after 3 years from the first time we decided, start thinking seriously about that, we are on production with a very, very huge, let's say, building, 160,000 square meters, which is a major building, the biggest building that Marcegaglia Group has always realized in his life at once. I mean, we have bigger plant, but it's been built in different steps through years. In China, it's the biggest one at one shot.
Do you foresee that investment coming back, and how do you see it manifesting in the next couple
of years?
I
think the liquidity in the system is there, and after what I would define, not only me, a bubble in the an inflation in the pricing of product, of shares of the steel of, in general, and in particularly of some commodity business, including steel. After that, I think there has been a decent readjustment. So I believe selectively, this will make the difference. Money will become again available for serious projects and let's say strong project long term. It will not be for everyone and it will not be for every kind of purpose, but I believe that yes, to a certain extent we could see investment coming back, probably with less short-term expectation, with a more realistic view, and as I said, for specific project. So I believe that the long-term perspective of the commodity business, including steel, is pretty bright. I believe that the industrialization of China will continue. India will be added. South America, Middle East, and some other areas will also, together with some other Asian country, will help. So the need of steel and the more, let's say, long-term perspective is positive. I think that the crisis makes some selection, and I think that was not so bad at the end. I also believe that some of the huge overcapacity risk has been stopped by this very, very cold shower that hit us all. And so at the end, I believe that there will be loser, there will be winner, but there will be a more sane and stronger structure in the steel industry overall, long term. And that will be positive for the investor as well.
You're a company that exists, I would say, largely on shorter term pricing mechanisms. Now, exchanges like the LME and the financial community are looking to address price risk management from a perspective of trading futures. As someone who's been managing risk in prices for quite some time, what advice do you have for other steel companies as we go into these uncharted waters?
Well, I'm not sure if the LME will be really successful in the, let's say, commodity carbon steel like hot roll and slabs. It may very well be. In my opinion, it may take a little more time. We proved that the value added has been moving up very significantly, so you need probably to take care more of the volatility of iron ore rather than in order to control the volatility of the hot roll or the slab. What advice I have? I believe that, as I said, volatility and the capability of reaction will be part of the game and will be probably a very important part of the game, because in the past, special liaison, knowledge of the market, knowledge of a kind of a hidden source in a very exotic country could make a difference for some time. Now it's over. We are in the information, let's say, era. All the information are available to everyone. There are also very important capable player, even if they're not very big but financially strong, who can buy as good as the very big giant or maybe a few dollars difference. So the real ability, and I see in this volatility not only a risk but also an opportunity for the smart player who can read the market ahead, who can understand what's next, who do not get confused about short-term and long-term mechanism. And I think the only advice I have to the overall world is, to the world of our steel world is, we do not have to really read the steel business on a quarterly basis. The financial guy and investor tend to get to an extreme one quarter to another. Steel business is for the long term. Steel business requires a lot of capital. The return of those capital could not be as good as in the last couple of years before the crisis. So the quarter or the short term has to be seen within a larger picture. This is my only, let's say, consideration. So volatility in between is an opportunity or it could be a risk. It depends. I don't think you can really offset volatility so much.
Mr. Marcegaglia, thank you very much indeed.
My pleasure. Thank you again. Thank you. See you tomorrow. You too.